Arena. It's CCX coverage of girls high school hockey. And tonight, it's the 21st annual Holiday Classic from New Hope. Hi, and welcome everybody, along with Dan Ficken. I'm Joe Moline, and Dan, tonight, an exciting matchup. Two teams not familiar with each other, different conferences. It's Minneapolis hockey team versus the Champlain Park Rebels. Champlain Park entered this tournament with their first game last night. They won 12-2 over Armstrong Cooper for Minneapolis. This is their first game of the tournament, but they come into this game, Dan, trying to get off a three-game losing streak.
Yeah, they're having some troubles. They got a 6-7 record, but they lost to Princeton 4-1 earlier this week. But this is a good opportunity. These holiday tournaments are fabulous for trying some new things, trying some new people, break some slumps, and get on a consistent run here. And that's what they're looking to do right now.
For Minneapolis, they have struggled scoring the puck a little bit lately, and looking for some scoring from some different players. Right now, a couple of players sitting around there, 5-6 goals, nobody in double digits so far. So one thing Minneapolis would really like to do is kind of get hot here tonight. And one of the people standing in their way is going to be a new goaltender, a sophomore goaltender for the Champlain Park Rebels, a goaltender that has not started yet this season, but did play and start 11 games last year as a freshman. So a new test, a challenge for both teams here tonight.
Well, good opportunity for Brooke Freeman. You know, she played last year a little varsity, hasn't done much this year. Sophomore goalie came in and really took charge of the job. So this is a good opportunity for her to get her feet back under again in case they need her. You know, it's a long season, Joe, and especially with sections, you lose a goalie, boy, you better have somebody backing up reliable. So this ought to be a fun opportunity for her tonight against Minneapolis.
And one thing that she has is the luxury of some good experienced defense. Coming into this game here tonight, Minneapolis struggling to score. Champlain Park, one thing that they really have, which Coach Coltis is very proud of, is a lot of stability back there on the blue line.
Well, it's really enabled him to do a lot of different stuff, too. He took a really good defense, Jordan Trapp, and moved her up now to get some scoring, and that was the problem he was having coming into this year. He was wondering where the goals were going to come. Well, I'll tell you what, she stepped up, man. 12 goals, 14 assists, and that has really helped them a lot. And that, by evidence of last night, 12 goals. Her and her two teammates had 7 goals out of the 12 last night.
Now, the tournament has changed a little bit. It used to be a 4-team round robin at one time. It had 8 teams and had a quarterfinal feel to it. Now we're with 5 teams, so each of these teams will get 3 games out of it, but the best record at the end wins the championship. And when Dan had an opportunity to ask both coaches, what's the goal? Well, for Minneapolis, it was get off the schneid a little bit, try to get a couple wins because they've been on that losing streak. Champlain Park, it's just win, baby. They're looking to go 3-0.
Well, and they want to. They want to put 3 together straight in 3 consecutive nights, just like you do in sections or in a state tournament. That's their test. Can you put 3 together in a row consistently and win? And it's about winning in this tournament for them. So I would assume they ain't going to be real, you know, merciful here. They're going to put it on and put it on good.
All right, it should be an excellent game. It's the Rebels from Champlain Park and the nameless mascot from Minneapolis. And it's We'll Drop the Puck next on CCX Sports.
What makes your community feel like home? Is it knowing what's happening in your neighborhood? Or when people know your name? Connections make us a community. For more than 30 years, Northwest Community Television has connected citizens, neighbors, even sports fans through video. As life gets busier than ever, we will still offer you a connected community experience through CCX Media, so you can stay connected to the place you call home.
And welcome back to the New Hope Ice Arena. Dan Ficken, Joe Moline here for the second night of the 21st annual Holiday Classic. As we are at the New Hope Ice Arena, home of the host of this tournament, the Armstrong Cooper Wings. And as we talked in the pregame, Dan, two teams offsetting goals a little bit. Minneapolis coming in, trying to get off the shine a little bit, break this losing streak, get some goals in the net as they've been really struggling from a scoring perspective. Champlain Park, on the other hand, strong defensively, led to a 2 games above 500 record. They're looking to see if they can't come out on top of this tournament as we face it off. And the Rebels win the opening faceoff. This is Trapp, one of the captains for the Rebels, coming down the left side, gets around the defender, loses the puck momentarily, but regains control. Behind the net she goes. Still with some space, she'll play it back to the point. That shot hits traffic in front, ricochets off to the side, and playing it neatly down into the corner is Megan Shook. A centering feed there, no one able to connect. Kaylee Wood plays it back down into the corner, racing after it goes Emily Schwartz for the Rebels. Schwartz defended there nicely by the Minneapolis defenseman behind the goal. It gets played up the wall. Here comes Minneapolis out of the zone. Long lead pass gets intercepted there at the blue line by Shook. Shook puts it back down to the Minneapolis zone, and Jane Carlson back to get it. Carlson sends it up the left wall, out of the zone as the Rebels regain control. And back into the zone comes Champlin Park. Shot from the top of the circle, that hits the defenseman. Rebound attempt, and they did get a shot on goal there as Lila Schultz put it aside nicely.
As we were talking to Coach Poulkis at Champlin Park before the game, he said he wanted to open up this first period, which is usually their best, with a very hard forecheck and do some pinching and bringing an extra forward in to really adapt. They just did that. They got off to a good start here, but Minneapolis now has gone it out, survived it, and they're down in the Rebel zone.
Minneapolis on the attack for the first time here tonight. Clear. Champlin Park now skating the puck up the wall. They'll bank it off the boards and out of the zone. Controlled there by Lucy Farm. She goes D to D. Julia Offerdahl, nice feed up ahead. Now here comes Minneapolis into the zone. Nifty stick handling there by Erica Lieske, but she was eventually defended as she came into the zone 1-on-3. Didn't have the numbers. Now Champlin Park with it. Hannah Lynn plays it out. And then Mackenzie Baker brings it into the zone. Baker shoots it from the top of the circle. Easy blocker save made by Schultz. Rebound gets all the way out of the zone. And this Champlin Park was in the middle of a line change. Now Sinjin tries to play it back to the blue line. Had that attempt denied. Alyssa Sweet back to get it. Sweet plays it up the far side wall there. Racing after it goes Sinjin. Sinjin into the zone 1-on-3. And puts it right into the mitt of Schultz for a stoppage of play.
Look at that, Lila Schultz here, junior goalie for Minneapolis. Got some pretty good stats here. She's 5-7-0 record-wise, 3.26 GAA, and an 8.76 save percentage. She's seen a lot of pucks, but she's done a good job for him.
Minneapolis will try to reverse it, go back to the far side. Waiting for it there was Georgia Chrisman. Chrisman going to retreat. Gives it back now to Whitney Knight. Her pass is intercepted. Champlin Park plays it right back down into the corner now. And Mackenzie Baker tried to cycle it down low to the near side. Minneapolis won the race to that one. Ava Miller reverses course, tries to go back the other way, but gets the puck taken right off her stick. Good forecheck by Wood. Wood tried to center, had it intercepted. And here comes Minneapolis out of the zone. Minneapolis on the rush. Chrisman shot from just inside the blue line. Save made as Brooke Freeman gets her first test of the night. Freeman kicked that one into the corner. Puck held in at the point nicely for a moment there by Offerdahl. Offerdahl can't hold it in now, but still fights for it and is able to put it back into the Champlin Park zone where they'll have to go D to D. Nice centering feed. Here come the Rebels. Killy Wood down the right side. Wood gets around a defender. Wood tries to center it. Couldn't quite connect there with Emily Schwartz. And Minneapolis comes back down. This will be icing as Erica Lieske did not get the right angle on that bank pass, and we'll have a faceoff coming back into the Minneapolis zone now with 13:20 to go in this scoreless first period.
Good faceoff win by Minneapolis here. Joe, I tell you, Champlin though has really done a great job of the forechecking. I mean, Minneapolis has had to go back and forth. I like the fact that Minneapolis is reversing. It's a good way to break a forecheck, but Champlin Park seems to be catching up to it.
Trapp centers it up front. Now a chance for Schwartz, and Schwartz puts one right on. But again, Lila Schultz able to make the save and no rebounds left.
Looking at the fourth-year head coach, Simon Polonos Osmond for Minneapolis. Had a nice talk with her, and she said, you know, the goal of this tournament right now is to get three games in and get off a three-game losing streak. So they're looking for a win here to get them going and get some consistent play going.
And their attempt there for Champlin Park as they tried to feed it out for Haley Williams. Now after it is Micah Sutherland. And it's taken away. Lucy Pham sticking us up to the half wall. Reverses, gives it back to McKinney. And McKinney finds Melnick, who got it out of the zone. And McKinney gets it back. Backhands it inside the Champlain Park blue line. Back to get it for the Rebels. And playing up the wall is Riley Foss. Foss, having trouble finding the puck here, now does find it. Foss gains the red line. And now gains the blue line and dumps it in backhand as Champlain Park goes for a wholesale line change. Tom back to get it for Minneapolis. A nice cross-ice pass here to Peterson. Peterson up and out of the zone. Gets to the red line. That's where she is met and denied. Nice play by Riley Foss. Gains control and then goes D to D. What a nice play by, excuse me, that wasn't Foss. That was Sweet. Sweet gave it over to Foss, and then Foss dumps it back in. But it's an icing on the Rebels. What a nice play there on the wall there to deny right at the red line.
Yeah, very nice. So they're just spying up and supporting each other really good. I like the way they're using everybody. They're spreading it out. We get a good look at Jim Koltis here, you know, one of the grand old men here. Jim, you know what I said, that of hockey. He's coached Maple Grove. Rogers has been a champion here for a number of years. And
he's been around so long, we were Channel 12 Sports when we last covered him.
Oh, boy.
Not CCX. Koltis, I've actually covered him while he's with Rogers and Maple Grove. He's been around our northwest suburbs for quite some time, leading his young girls in hockey and did a good job.
Used to coach against him when I was at Osseo.
Well, that's he's been out a long time then.
Yeah, very long time, especially an old guy like me. Good guy, nice guy, very well-mannered, courteous, respectful guy, and he's always done a good job with the programs.
And one thing interesting about hockey is every rink can have its own dimensions, and one thing you'll notice here at this rink, very deep behind the nets, and there's a lot of room to work back there, and that's what Champlain Park's trying to take advantage of. Jane Carlson now gives it off to Ava Miller. Miller, and a nice breakout pass here. Here comes Chrisman. Chrisman up to the zone. A 1-on-4, though, and that's kind of been the story of the night so far. When Minneapolis finally does get it out, they've got to go for a line change, so they haven't had the odd man numbers. Now here comes a chance for Champlain Park as they come down. Colford got it knocked off her stick, and Champlain Park the same thing. They come down into the zone, had to go for a change. Travels into the Rebels zone, picked up by Sutherland. Sutherland with a nice pass up ahead to Jordan Trapp. Trapp gives it a near side to Schwartz. Schwartz puts one right on. Rebound attempt in front. Sprawling and covering that one up is Lila Schultz, as that was her biggest test of this first period yet.
Great leg save coming out here. Unfortunately, she was stretched out so doggone far, she left a big rebound. Nice save there. Was trying to get back. Didn't quite control it into the corner. Glance off, and Champlain got another opportunity as they swarmed the net there.
Face-off won by the Rebels. Sutherland dumps it back down into the corner. Nice forecheck there as Wood gains control. Now walks it in from a sharp angle, put it right on. Now puts it back to the point. Trapp didn't like what she saw from a shooting angle. Now gets it right back. What a nice return feed, and she finds the back of the net.
That was tipped in front.
Good patience as Trapp played it back to the point, and Alyssa Sweet finds its way through traffic.
Kaylee Wood, I think, got a tip on that one, 27. Beautiful, it was coming in, and she just tipped it down into the five hole and beat Lila Schultz.
And I'll apologize, it's Hannah Lynn with the shot from the point, so there's Lynn, and I think you're right, Dan,
yeah.
What a tip.
Nice tip. You couldn't have done that any better.
And that is why they work on those tip drills in practice, friends. Kaylee Wood, what a goal.
She's excited. She had, I think she had herself a hat trick last night against Armstrong Cooper.
So Wood will get the goal. Lynn will get one assist, and Trapp should get the other. Trapp's the one that made the nice heads-up play of getting that pass down to the corner and then go right back to the point. It's amazing how giving a pass like that, the way Lynn did, freed her up for an eventual shot. She didn't have a shooting lane at first glance, got it back, and had a shot shooting lane.
So the most important thing from a D point shot is, first of all, don't hit the shin pads of the forward coming out at you. And number two, you don't have to get it on there. Just get it close and let your forwards do their work, and it worked to perfection that time. A great tip. I'm getting a good answer back here from Minneapolis. They're putting a decent forecheck in and not letting Champa get back down their own zone. They're working them pretty good right now.
Sutherland plays it up the left wall and out of the zone. Minneapolis back to get it inside their blue line, and it's Carlson to get it. Carlson goes D to D. Try to go back to the near side here. Waiting for it, there's Gaffney. Gaffney goes back now to Chrisman. And Minneapolis trying to build up some momentum as they come to the neutral zone. They'll dump it in and go on the forecheck here. Fresh skaters on the ice so they can continue on the forecheck. Chrisman plays it back behind the goal. Nice positioning back there by Lynn. Now she gets some help. And it's Emily Peterson playing up the right wing. Nice chipped out by Sinjim. That frees up the Rebels. Minneapolis plays it back, but they turn it over. And Sutherland gains control. Nice little circle away from the pressure. Sutherland gaining some speed across the red line. Had her angle taken away, so she dumps it in. Heads to the bench for a line change. And Miller back to get it. Miller plays it up the wall. Waiting for it there is Melnick. Melnick
nice move.
Gets across the red line. Inside the Champlain Park zone. Puts the brakes on. Looking for some help. There's no defenseman as they're changing. But what a good play of getting that puck down deep into the corner.
He tried that delay. It was just trying to find some help. Maybe create something. Kind of somebody coming late in the net. Good play, but didn't see anybody. Okay, made a nice play and got it down deep.
Carlson there tried to get into the red line, but had it taken away by Kaylee Wood. We've seen Wood do that a number of times here. She just overpowers some players in getting that puck. It's trapped down behind the goal. Trap centers it, but that's intercepted. And Leeske is able to play it up the left wing. And chipping it to center is Melnick. Melnick chases after it. Can't win the race. And the Rebels gain control. Here comes Trapp. From the top of the circle, she lets one fly. And Schulz will kick that one into the netting and out of play. Schulz seeing her fair share of pucks here in this first period. 7:19 to go. And the Rebels lead 1-0.
Good idea. This nice opportunity right here. Good shot taken, and you can see that tip real clear. Took it off the heel and stick and dropped it down. Kept it below the waist. Just a pretty, pretty play.
Off the faceoff, Champlain Park control. Sutherland plays it down into the corner. And Lever plays it behind the net. Now Lever with a chance, two attempts, maybe even a third. Lever was denied. Now Lever still with it, brings it back out. Can't get much on that shot. And Champlain Park still with control now. Sutherland will pinch in from the point, keep the puck active. Sutherland, look at the hustle from the Rebels. Behind the goal, centering. That gets denied, but she gets it right back on her stick, and she'll cycle it back down low. Now Williams after it. Williams gets tied up there along the wall, but wins the battle, still centers it. Nobody home there for the Rebels. And Minneapolis will get it out. Skating at the center there is Peterson. Peterson has it lifted right off her stick, and the Rebels come back on the attack. 3-on-3 as they enter the zone. A shot there. That one misses wide up the stick of Lever. And here comes Minneapolis. 2-on-1. Best chance of the night now. Knight comes down and gives it. Tries to find McKinney. And they could not connect on that 2-on-1.
Just a saucer pass away from a good-looking 2-on-1. But the Champlain D stepped up really nice. Got a stick in the lane. Just deflected the puck enough so it went behind the second player coming in from Minneapolis.
Hannah Lynn with one assist, goes back to retrieve the puck, rings it around the far side. Minneapolis defender keeps it in for a moment, gets pinched off and then hit taken away. And Champlain Park's Mackenzie Baker brings it into the zone. Offerdahl was able to avoid the forecheck and then gave way there to Chrisman. Chrisman makes the cross ice pass to Gaffney, and Gaffney will toss it into the zone before she heads to the bench. Now this is Lynn. Easy breakout pass up the left wing to Sinjam, who gets it taken right away. Leeske. Lynn will bank it off the glass to the neutral zone. Minneapolis now gains control. Sinjam into the zone. Down the left side. Good stick work there. Gets it taken away, but then following it up with a shot attempt, but never getting it to the net. As Minneapolis is Lauren Melnick. Saw the defensive play there from Sweet. Just a really active stick to deny that rush from Minneapolis. Yeah. Now Sweet has the puck bounce over her stick. Sweet will take it back behind our goal where she tries to buy some time. Puts the brakes on now. Surveys the forecheck. Makes a nice pass to Sinjim. Sinjim plays it out to center. Melnick has it taken off her stick. Here comes Schwartz into the zone. 1-on-4. And misses wide, but it ends up right in the stick of Trapp, who plays it right back down low to Schwartz. Schwartz goes after in the corner. finds Trapp. Trapp tried to give it to her on a give and go. Schwartz just wasn't on the same page.
Boy, that was dangerous. Wood was all alone in front of the net. If they just could have just saucer passed that over to her, that would have been a dangerous moment for Minneapolis.
4:01 to go in the first period. We have an icing on Minneapolis, and the faceoff will come back down into the zone where a lot of the play has happened here tonight, to our left.
Well, Coach Koltis told us, he said he felt he was pretty solid with his 5D. And again, he allowed him to make a couple moves here, but I'll tell you what, they have been solid tonight. They're really keeping Minneapolis off to the side or far out, so they aren't getting anything inside, nor have they had a deep rush onto Freeman, the champion goalie.
3:58 to go in the first period. Off the faceoff, shot right on there from the point. Good looking ripper for Megan Shook. Trapp with it in the corner. Trapp getting most off the puck. No one really there to help her as Wood was slow to get down there. Now Wood gets to it, plays it back down into the far corner. Trapp will go on the forecheck. She wins the race, being a little bit more aggressive. Champlain Park winning a lot of those individual battles along the boards at this point in the game and just having way more puck possession and zone possession because of it.
Yeah, they're essentially making Minneapolis worry about playing defense, especially keeping things out from in front of the net, not even thinking about a breakout.
Wood tries to split the defenders, loses the puck. Minneapolis will come out to center now. Into the zone comes Minneapolis. Siri Hansen dumps it in behind the goal. Champlain Park with some speed through center. Now comes Holly Johnson. Johnson will dump it in and chase after it. Johnson races after it. Offerdahl is the first one there for Minneapolis. Offerdahl pinned up against the boards by Johnson. Now kicks it free. Minneapolis again will try to reverse it, but then pinching down from the point and keeping it down was Champlain Park's Hannah Lynn. Minneapolis eventually did get it out. Champlain Park now taking up as Haley Williams brings it in. She'll dump it down into the corner. Rebels continue on to the forecheck here. A nice centering feed there by Lever. Was denied by Gaffney on a nice defensive play. Icing's going to be waved off, so we have a good race for the puck here. And showing her speed there was Sutherland. Sutherland got to that puck and then calmly got it off to one of her teammates for a perfect breakout. Here comes Trapp. Let's see some speed in the open ice. Trapp all the way in. Trapp off the goalie mask. And the rebound sits there as Lila Schultz, after getting her bell rung, was able to cover up.
Wow. Trapp with an amazing amount of speed right now. Gets in tight here with the stick bothering, but she brings her hips into play so she can get everything into that shot and just puts it right up into the face mask of Lila Schultz. And that causes a rebound, obviously, but covered up. Schultz keeping Minneapolis in this game so far.
Bouncing puck in front. And a chance there for Champlain Park, but it gets played into the corner before Schwartz could get a shot off. Schwartz and a good job on the forecheck, intercepted a pass. Now it trickles back to the point. Megan Shook didn't get a good shooting lane, so she plays it back down low. Now Shook gets it back, pinching in from the point. Now playing forward for a moment here. Shook trying to get it out front, does so. Puck sitting there, and a shot attempt. Now Trapp gets a chance. Boy, Minneapolis not able to get the puck out of the zone, but they sure are doing a good job in front of their net.
Nobody's standing really free anymore. And when they do get the puck, they're getting trapped down by the Minneapolis D. They're doing a good job that way.
Ava Miller brought the puck into the zone. And getting it there is Leeske. On the zone comes Shook. And it's dumped down into the zone. Minneapolis. Cross ice pass gets intercepted. Here comes the Rebels. And a goal! Leah Heerwald takes a turnover and turns it into a 2-0 Rebels lead.
Junior does a good job here coming in straight away and just gets off to the side a little bit and rips it into the opposite corner. So she went right, drew the gully in that direction, and ripped it into the lower left corner.
Well, she intercepted that pass and was off to the races, and the first goal of the game was scored by Wood, who's accustomed to scoring. She got her 15th of the year. This one here is only the second goal of the season. for Leah Herwald. That's a big goal right there, because a 2-0 lead feels a lot different than a 1-0 lead. But here's a chance for Minneapolis, backhander on. And up at the task there was Brooke Freeman making that kick save. Minneapolis retreats, gets the puck here, 3 seconds to go. Let's see if they can't get one last shot from Gaffney. And the buzzer sounds as Gaffney enters the Champlain Park zone.
Well, interesting period. Good one for Champlain Park. They've also done a good job of keeping the leading score, 22 Alex Gaffney, really a non-essential in this game. Forcibly defense, I don't think she has one shot yet. And Minneapolis got to change that. They got to get her back out on the ice more and let her go and give her more opportunities. Kaylee Wood, beautiful setup here. Did a nice job tipping a puck in for the first goal to break the ice. And Champlain gets a second one here at the end with Leah Herwald, and they got a 2-0 lead.
Right now, Champlain Park's team speed and ability to win those battles along the boards is what giving Minneapolis the most trouble. Minneapolis, when they get the puck down into the Champlain Park zone, a lot of times they're able to dump it and have to get off. They haven't had a lot of scoring chances on their end. And Champlain Park, a clean first period, but they were able to really forecheck without getting into any kind of penalty trouble or sacrificing and giving up any odd man rushes. When you can have that kind of forecheck and your defensemen are that aggressive at the blue line and you're not giving up odd man rushes, that's a good luxury to have if you're Champlain Park.
Absolutely.
Champlain Park won last night 12-2 to start off this 21st annual Holiday Classic Tournament. Now they're up 2-0 over Minneapolis, so they're off to a good start of accomplishing that goal of going 3-0 and winning the championship here.
Well, they've been aggressive, and Jim Colton said too, he wanted to be very aggressive in this first period. Really put a heavy forecheck on. I think they accomplished that, Joe. And we'll see how much that wears down Minneapolis here, especially in the third period. Play a lot of defensive hockey, your legs get tired real fast.
And we're going to send it down now to Coach, to John Jacobson, who's standing by with Coach Osmond of Minneapolis.
All right, thanks, Joe. And Coach, always tough to give up those late period goals, isn't it?
It is. I just hope we come back strong in the second period.
Tell me overall about your team's play in that first period. What did you like about what you saw?
I like our pace of play. Champlain's a little bit faster than our last few opponents, so we started to adjust to that. I still think we have to move the puck a little quicker and take more ice from our defensive zone.
Holiday tournament's always a little bit of a challenge, and that now you've got three games in 3 days. What do you try to get across to the girls as they try to get through, that many games in a short amount of time?
Right. We'd like to see consistency, and I do think we came out strong in that period, and I'd like to see a consistent effort and belief that they can do it in the second period.
Overall, tell me about your season, how it's gone for Minneapolis so far.
Pretty good. We have a good group of girls, probably the closest team we've had in several years. So that's one thing we have going for us, is a close-knit team that really genuinely cheers for each other. So each game, we're going as hard as we can, and everybody's going for each other, which is the best part of our season so far.
How big of a challenge is it when you've got girls from different schools trying to come together for one program, get them together for practice, and just have them be a team?
I think it actually benefits us, because they don't see each other every day at school, so it's kind of something to look forward to when they get to the rink and they see their friends that they haven't seen all day, so it benefits us.
Finally, what needs to improve for you the last two periods to win this one?
We need to generate more shots, for sure, and get to pucks quicker, move the puck quicker, but I have full confidence they can do it.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck the rest of the game.
Thanks.
Tom Osmond, head coach of Minneapolis. They trail 2-0 against Champlain Park through one period. We'll come back with more of the Armstrong Cooper Holiday Classic from New Hope Arena after this timeout.
Most of my family, they never graduated high school or even let alone go to college, so I'm trying to break that barrier. Every day after work, went straight to school, studied hard, and it paid off. I could not have done it alone. I see the future is really bright for me. The high school diploma is just added to the confidence, and now I feel unstoppable.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
They said a bottle was just a bottle. That no one would ever notice me. But I knew I could be more. That one day, I would make people smile.
The color in my garden keeps the pink of my cheeks. I was very independent and thought I could take care of myself. I fell and I had to have Meals on Wheels. They're my savior. My name is Lola Silvestri. America, let's do lunch.
Drop off a hot meal and say hello. Volunteer by donating your lunch break at americaletsdolunch.org.
I adopted Bento in 2010 from a shelter. As it turns out, we have very similar personalities. And this cat makes me make art because he's always motivating me to take pictures of him, to draw pictures of him. He just is motivating artistically. It's just that simple. Well, he's my best friend, but a lot of people know him as Keyboard Cat.
What makes your community feel like home? Is it knowing what's happening in your neighborhood? Or when people know your name? Connections make us a community. For more than 30 years, Northwest Community Television has connected citizens, neighbors, even sports fans through video. You can learn about the latest news through our truly local newscast. We cover and air around 150 high school sporting events every year. For our cities, we air parades and city meetings that you can watch whenever you want. Then, any citizen of our cities can create and share their own original content. We'll even teach you how to use the equipment too. We have always provided you with a connected community experience. And as life gets busier than ever, we will continue to engage, inform, and inspire through CCX Media so you can stay connected to the place you call home.
Welcome back to New Hope Ice Arena. We're in between periods and joined now by Tournament Director Chris Winter from the Armstrong Cooper Girls Hockey Program. And Chris, always a challenge to put together any tournament. Tell me about the work that you and the committee has done to get ready for these 4 days of the tournament.
Sure, yeah, it's a great event. We love hosting it every year. This is our 21st year, so it's a fantastic opportunity not only to involve the girls in great hockey and so forth, but also the community. We get a lot of community sponsorships, Frankie's Pizza and Topper's Pizza and a bunch of other community businesses around really kind of help support the group. Really, it starts the day after the tournament ends. We have to start looking at next year, start booking the ice time, start looking at who's going to come in and wants to be in the competition.
I know this wasn't the ideal number of teams you ended up with. You had five teams. You had six lined up a couple of times, but unfortunately, teams dropped out late.
Yeah, that's sometimes it happens. Summer situations change, you know, and teams got to make a decision after the end of it all. So we unfortunately had to kind of scramble a little bit at the last time and do it instead of a bracket play, a little bit of a round robin play. So
your daughter's a junior on the team. How much fun is that to watch as a parent?
Oh, it's great. Well, it's a wonderful experience. It's a good program. She's been on it for a number of years, and so she's got a couple more years and looking forward to it on defense.
You know, I've talked to the girls who have played in this tournament before. Last year, some of the alumni from that first tournament 20 years ago came back. Is it fun to see some of those players and them involved in local hockey?
It really is. We always have an alumni game. It happened to be earlier this week and so forth. It was a fantastic turnout. We had about 20 girls from the alumni over all the years. Some of them haven't been on skates for a number of years, so it's always great to see them on there. You could tell from the smile on their faces through the face mask. They were having a good time out there.
For you working with the Booster Club, what are some of the things that you're involved in supporting this team?
You know, really, the goal for the Booster Club is to really support the coaches and the team. What do they need and how can we help facilitate that process for them as best as possible? A lot of fundraising, as you can imagine.
Right, so fundraising. So what are some of the things that you fundraise for?
Well, we fundraise for it. We're trying to get the girls on an away trip, get them out, a little team bonding, also get them experience in a kind of a northern, some northern teams and so forth, get them up there, whatever. We also fundraise for uniforms, equipment, you know, just the standard stuff on a regular basis.
Do your varsity players get involved too with youth hockey, either during the season or during the summer, trying to get girls in the community involved to keep the Armstrong Cooper program going in the future?
It is. You know, it's the future of the program, as you know. And so we not only does the we have a wings program that we invite younger girls to come up and skate with the players during warm-ups, really gets them involved in an early age and so forth. But we also have the coach actually does a lot of summer activities with the entire youth program.
Chris, thanks for your time. Good luck the rest of the tournament.
Thanks for being here, guys. Appreciate it.
Chris Winter, tournament director here for the Holiday Classic at New Hope Ice Arena. We'll take a break, come back with more of our intermission after this on CCX Sports.
I see you mobbing over her. Let's go. Let's mob. Let's crawl. Let's crawl. Let's crawl. Hey, yo, we mobbing. Come on, girl. Let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl. Hey, let's crawl. Hey, yo, let's crawl.
I rescued Toast from a shelter in 2011. I love Toast because she's a lazy diva. Toast does whatever she wants, obviously. She's sleeping right now. She's an epic snuggler. She's so comforting. She's so loving. Toast makes me laugh. When I walked into the shelter, I knew right then that she was special.
Welcome back to the Armstrong Cooper Holiday Classic with the Champlain Park Rebels up 2-0 after one period over Minneapolis. It was all Rebels in that first period. A lot of shots on goal. Not many for Minneapolis. There was one of three. Champlain Park peppering the goaltender, Lila Schultz, in this first period. A couple of opportunities there for the Rebels. And crashing the net. And finally here, a nice little tip-in off the stick of Keely Wood, getting her 15th goal of the season, 27th point for the captain of the Rebels. And Champlain Park gets another one right there. That's only the second goal of the year for junior Leah Heerwald, as she intercepted a pass at center ice, who took that one in and buried it for that 2-0 lead. That was a late period goal to give them that 2-0 lead. It'll be interesting to see how Minneapolis bounce back from that. Here's your shots on goal. Rebels leading 13-3 in that category. Scoring chances also in favor of the Rebels, 5-0. No penalties in that first period. Nice, evenly played, smooth game in respect to the physicality. And Champlain Park, again, just bringing a little more speed than what Minneapolis is accustomed to seeing. You heard the coach Osmond talk about that and how she would like to see her team adjust even better than they did in that first period. Well, there you have it. The ice is cleaned off. The Zamboni's back in, and the girls are ready to come back out. We're going to take a quick break, and then we'll drop the puck for the second period here on CCX.
What makes your community feel like home? Is it knowing what's happening in your neighborhood, or when people know your name? Connections make us a community. For more than 30 years, Northwest Community Television has connected citizens, neighbors, even sports fans through video. As life gets busier than ever, we will still offer you a connected community experience through CCX Media, so you can stay connected to the place you call home.
Every time I hear the alarm bell go off in school, I think it's an air raid.
A lot of houses in our neighborhood have been destroyed. I like to close my ears and sing songs whenever the bombs come close.
I'm worried our new neighbors won't like us.
But I know it's all gonna be worth it. I just want my family to be safe. But these are not my
words.
These
are not my words.
These are not my words.
And we're back at the New Hope Ice Arena. 21st Annual Anderson Armstrong Cooper Girls Hockey Tournament. Along with Dan Ficken, I'm Joe Moline. Champlain Park in the dark blue uniforms is going to be going left to right here. And Champlain Park coaching staff, get with it. Come on.
You're holding up a hockey
game,
boys.
Holding up the show here.
Come
on. All the players are ready to go, and the coaches hadn't made their way to the bench yet. That was the momentary delay as Minneapolis wins the faceoff to be in the second period. Jane Carlson, going partner Winnie Knight. White with a long pass to the neutral zone, does not connect, and this will be icing on Minneapolis.
Well, Minneapolis got to come out now, and they got to start breaking that forecheck that Champlain's put on him. I'm sure there's some strategy about reversing and flying somebody maybe out of the zone to get the defense to back off a little bit and create some things, take over the neutral zone and try to fly in.
Trap taking the faceoff here for Champlain Park, but it's Minneapolis who wins it. Olivia Gaffney put it down into the corner. Minneapolis gets it back to the point, but a shot there kept in the zone and put on goal from Megan Shook.
Champlain's jumping on every little mistake, too. I mean, a missed pass, a little bit behind, a little bit ahead. The defense is grabbing onto it real quick and just sending it right back into the zone.
Nice win on the faceoff and a scoring chance right off the draw as Schwartz let that one fly. Went off the blocker of Schultz. Race for the puck on the far side. After it goes Ava Miller. Miller ties it up there. Trap harassing her and taking it away. Then Trap plays it down into the near corner. That's where Schwartz wins the race to that one. Schwartz pinned up against the boards. Tries to keep it pinned up there, looking for some help. Eventually, Minneapolis, who outnumbers Champlain Park in the corner, look like they're going to win the battle. But again, it's the Rebels winning those battles. I said one-on-one battles. That was a two-on-three battle that they won. Hannah Lynn back to get it there. She gets tied up along the board, but she got some help there from Shuck. Shuck plays it off the wall, tipped to the middle of the ice there and kept in. Chrisman fires one. That one misses wide. Nice lift of the stick by Riley. Tried to center it. Now Riley on a second attempt. Tried to pull one on net, but missed wide. Minneapolis with not many chances has to try to at least get those type of shots on goal.
Throw every piece of rubber you can at the Champlain goalie. Just start ringing it. No matter where you are, get it on net.
You don't need to be picky when you only have three shots on goal in the first period. Now a shot from the point there. That one hits the defender out in front. Held in at the point now by Minneapolis. Fanning on that dump attempt is offered all, but after it goes Melnick. Melnick gets tied up. Melnick going to battle there one on two against the Rebels. The Rebels win that one. And it's now put up the wall. Cross ice pass there by Lever. Gets it over to Johnson, who dumps it into the zone for Minneapolis. Now Minneapolis comes back out. Here comes Minneapolis down. Leeske down the left side. She got taken down by Shook. Now a centering pass there. That one misses. Does not connect. Now Champlain Park again with a centering feed that just goes too far. And with that clean, clean ice, that puck has too much momentum. It's going to go for icing. Faceoff coming back down inside the Champlain Park zone. And anytime you're outplayed in the game, I always think faceoffs, offensive zone faceoffs, off icings are a great opportunity to try to get something going.
No, absolutely. But the kick is, you got to win them. Get them to the right person. Get a shot set up. Get it on net.
Elda Melnick will be in charge of trying to win this faceoff for the team in white, Minneapolis. She goes right to the net. Gets it to the net, but not a really hard shot. Easy cover up there for Freeman.
Well, that's okay, though, Joe. That's a win. You know, they got it on net. They got something going. And as soon as the forwards learn to get down there, that's where the puck is going. Now we see Champlain Park make a change.
Rebels will roll their top line out there. And going to take the draw there is Kaylee Wood.
Coach Coltis didn't like that faceoff loss.
Freeman will cover another one up here.
Well, when you get a little bit of trouble, that's what you do. Put your best players out there and they can get it out of the zone for you.
Melnick and Wood. Wood wins that one cleanly. And Sutherland goes behind her own net with the puck. Nice little reversal there, but not a clean pass off to Foss, but Foss hustles after and good persistence right there as she banks it out to center. Minneapolis will come back down in. McKinney gets across the red line. McKinney can't get it down deep, though, and Champlain Park comes the other way. Here comes Wood down the right side. Wood cuts across the middle, has it poked away, though. Good defensive play there. She was met by Lucy Riley. Wood with it again in the corner. Wood's got a little jump in her step here. Found tap. Couldn't get much on that. It was a little fluttering chip shot with the backhand, and then missed wide. Now Wood trying to get it to trap again. That one was a little bit too far ahead of her and defended nicely by the Minneapolis decor in front. Peterson gets it for Minneapolis, gets away from one forechecker, but then shoves it into the skates of another. Now Minneapolis finally gets to the line, still not out. Trap dumps it right back down into the corner, and Minneapolis will have to go down and get it once again. These are those tough lines, or tough shifts rather, that sometimes lead to pucks in the back of your net when you just can't quite get off the ice. Legs are starting to get heavy.
Well, Coach Colt has got that top line out there again because they were getting pressure by Minneapolis, and all of a sudden, wham, that top line just turns it around, and now Minneapolis is in trouble. They can't get out of their own zone.
Minneapolis will skate this one to safety. Getting across the red line. Now it's finally tossed into the zone there by Melnick as Minneapolis finally able to get that line change. Gaffney stayed on the ice to put some pressure on the puck. Otherwise, everyone from Minneapolis was able to get off. Now Minneapolis will bank it off the boards. Not able to hold it in at the line was Lynn. Lynn dumps it right back in. Now Minneapolis skates it out. That's Offerdahl. Offerdahl into the zone, down the left side. Met defensively by Lynn. Lynn rings it around the far side. Waiting for it there was Williams. Champa Perks able to get it out of the zone to the neutral. Here comes Offerdahl again. Offerdahl tried to center it, had it intercepted. And now it's picked up there by Sweet. Sweet with some speed across the red line. She'll flick it in. Chase after it. She wins the race back behind the goal. Now Sweet on her backhand here. We'll turn around and dump it and cycle it back down low. Champlain Park very good at playing the wall game.
Well, like you said, Joe, they've been winning that one-on-one battle on the wall. They just soon have it up there because they keep walking out with it.
They know when they're in trouble and they don't have anything. Instead of just throwing it out front and turning it over, they dump it right back down and get that cycle going.
Yep.
There's a nice deflection. Good stick there by Georgia Chrisman, who came out there to block that shot at the point. Now a center feed. That one went right through the crease all the way to the far wall. Chrisman races after it, banks to the boards, but not out of the zone. Minneapolis still can't get it out. Nice keep there by Champlain Park. And now Minneapolis gets it out. Race for the puck on the far side. Comes Gaffney. Gaffney's hauled down. Well, the penalty and a good scoring chance as following the playoff was Chrisman, one of the leading scorers for Minneapolis with 5 goals on the year. Chrisman had a golden opportunity, but it's Gaffney who gets hauled down and draws our first penalty of the game.
Good play by Gaffney here, too. You know, she's our leading scorer, and she made something happen. She got a tripping penalty and then got the puck over to Chrisman, one of the other better players, who got an opportunity. So I would suspect here real quick, this line for Minneapolis is going to take what they get about 30 seconds, and then they're going to bring that Gaffney line back out here again.
Well, Gaffney actually came right back out, so they actually put their
she
top. They're tired.
Okay.
They were kind of, you know, bending over at the waist there because that was a long shift for them, but they rolled their top line out there for that to start the power play. Riley behind her goal. Goes far side to Knight. Scooping it up there is Leeske. Here comes Whitney Knight across the red line. Knight gets down the left side. Got to give her some help now. Trap edge dropped the puck nicely. Trap runs into some trouble behind the goal though. Minneapolis gains control. Bank pass to the boards. To the point rather. Now back down into the corner. Controlled there by Gaffney. Gaffney gets it back behind her net. Gaffney looking, tries to center it. And that one was defended nicely and now cleared all the way down by Williams. Minneapolis forwards will go for a line change. They'll get a new power play unit out here with 56 seconds to go in the power play. Now another takedown, this one not called, as it was Micah Sutherland who took down a Minneapolis player. Sutherland's keeping after it, buying some time now. Sutherland circles away. They got a double teamer. They got the man advantage, you got to double team the puck. Sutherland continuing to kill time off this penalty. Good effort there individually.
Just a water bug, you know. She must be all the 5 foot if that.
Leeske.
And did a great job there, just killing penalty time.
Chrisman goes to the point but puts it on the backhand of Miller. Miller does a nice job of recovering and making a decent pass to her partner. Now scooping it up again is Melnick. Melnick, top of the circle. Melnick tries to center it. And just quite couldn't quite get a stick on it. There was Gaffney. Gaffney was in tight against the goal. Ava Miller dumps it in, back to get it. It is shook for Champlain Park. She sends it on the far side. Champlain Park still has the puck in their zone, but they did complete the penalty kill with really no good scoring chances as a result. Minneapolis never really got it going.
Came close a couple of times, my gosh. I tell you, if they would add a foot, another forward in front of the net, they might have had an opportunity.
This is Offerdahl with it. Offerdahl gives it off to Knight. Knight to the neutral zone. All the way across the Champlain Park blue. Tries to center it, but has it intercepted. Now a turnover in front. Nope. Nice recovery. Looked like it was going to be a Champlain Park turnover right in front of the net there by Holly Johnson, but she recovered. And the Rebels were able to get it out of the zone. Chance there for Holly Johnson. She didn't like the angle of the shot. Chance she took it behind the goal. You don't see people pass up shots too often. She passed one up there to see if she could find something better. In hindsight, she probably should let it fly. Nice chip right there to get around the forechecking or the pinching defenseman. Here comes Minneapolis. Chrisman down the side, puts a shot right on. Freeman makes a save.
It was actually a pretty nice save by Freeman there. Joe was right on the opposite corner of the net. She got her leg out and just deflected off in the corner, but Chrisman creating some opportunity along with Gaffney there, number 22 and number 10.
Well, you think Freeman, you saw her smile right there. She's pretty happy to be between the pipes for the varsity team again. Played 11 games last year as a freshman. And this year, you know, nothing bad happened. She didn't do anything wrong. You know, according to Coach Coldis, just got out, you know, someone just worked hard and outplayed her. Bailey Shook got the majority of the starts so far this season. Shook off to a good start, 7-4 with a 2.12 goals against average and one shutout on the year.
Well, in their conference too, that Northwest Suburban, though, it's pretty tough. Maple Grove is there, Elk River's there, Centennial's there. Oh, you know, Powers, Blaine.
And right now, Champlain Park is two games above 500 overall. They're about 500 in their conference schedule, but they haven't really hit the difficult part of their conference schedule as well. Some of those tough teams you just mentioned are kind of looming on the schedule when January rolls around.
Well, the only thing about Champlain Park is this year, if you notice, they beat the teams they're supposed to beat, and they're having trouble beating the teams that maybe they should have some trouble with, but they did stay within one goal of Rogers and of Spring Lake Park, and Coach Bolton said he thought I should have won both those games. That would have kind of changed the record and the outlook, but still, I mean, when you got to deal with Maple Grove and Elk River and Blaine, Centennial, those are the games that you test yourself against. That's how you make a measurement of your progress.
Minneapolis nearly sprung Alex Gaffney there for a breakaway. The puck just couldn't quite find her stick, and she wasn't on the right edge to get there, but it was covered up before she could do anything as well. Chance kind of by the wayside there. Minneapolis struggling to get the puck out of their zone here. Good forecheck coming from Champlain Park. On the forecheck is Schwartz. Schwartz trying to outmuscle that defenseman down low. Her and Olivia Gaffney doing battle. Olivia Gaffney gains control of the puck, plays it back down into the corner. Fanning on that pass attempt was Offerdahl. Now Offerdahl hits the deck with Schwartz. Both players to their feet now. Schwartz back up and continuing to be a thorn on the side of this breakout. Schwartz steals the puck again. Look at Schwartz. Look at her work. Now she finds, oh, she found trap, a trap fan on it. Now at the point. Shot misses wide of the goal. Caroms off the back wall into the back of the net. And after it goes Lever, who centers it for Schwartz. Schwartz is on her backhand, and she's got to be nearly out of gas. And usually when players fall like that, that's kind of a good indication. Schwartz now plays it back down low. She's going to stay on the ice here, getting some help from Wood. Wood tries to center it out front from Sutherland had snuck down from the point. Now Wood turns, gets it to her forehand, but has that shot blocked. Schwartz with it in the corner. Schwartz gets away from one defender. Schwartz looking, backhands it right into the midsection, though, of Schultz. And Schultz will hang on as about 10 players on the ice. They're happy to have a whistle there as they all need a line change. Woo!
Look at this play right here. Comes around, see nobody's there. Trying to go for the upper corner there, the upper left-hand side. She had a heck of a shift. Heck of a shift. Just wrecked Minneapolis.
Couldn't quite just find the... Every time she got open, she kind of was on her backhand, but she got a backhand around there. Trapp was sitting in the back door, just chomping on the bits, waiting for a rebound. 5 minutes to play here in the second period. 2-0 Champlain Park. We got to this period with a 2-0 lead, too, so it's been even here in the second period, at least in terms of score. A lot of the play still down in that Minneapolis zone. I got to say, though, Minneapolis hasn't given up quite as many shots they did in that first period, even though the play happens to be in their zone.
Well, they've shut it down pretty good in front. They're covering everybody up. They continue to lose the battles on the boards there, that the one-on-ones and the two-on-ones, whatever, and just can't get it out.
Puck was tied up there. Off to the point, shot from the top of the circle, and seeing that one clearly was Lila Schultz. Schultz comes into this game with a 5-7 record, 3.26 goals against average. And Schultz in Minneapolis looking to improve on last year's 8-16-1 record. They already have 6 wins, 7 losses, so they're on their way to maybe get above that 8-win mark they had a year ago, but they have to get out of this 3-game lull that they're in.
Well, here's the good news, though, Joe. Here's the good news. This is a very young team. They are playing 8th, 9th, and 10th graders on this team, and they'll grow and develop as they continue to play at the varsity hockey level.
And they've made some big improvements. I mean, they're at 6 wins already. They had 8 last year. Schultz last year had a goals against average 1.25 above where she's at now. So they've cut down on some of the goals against. They're just looking for some goal scoring now to kind of put them over the top. Nice pinch there defensively from Melissa Sweet to keep the puck down low, but Minneapolis eventually sends it all the way down. Hannah Lynn back to get it for the Rebels. Lynn takes it behind her goal, stops, and then comes back up the middle with it. Nice breakout pass to Lever. Lever gets across the red line. She'll dump it into the zone. Minneapolis zone and bank it off the boards there. Now Minneapolis with a clean breakout. This will give them a chance here. 3-on-3 at center. And they don't complete the pass there at the blue line of Champlain Park. Minneapolis, they're going to say they tugged up. So puck was into the zone. On the forecheck they go.
But they should have given that pass to that winger a little bit sooner so she ran out of time to really get some speed and dig it down deep into the zone. By the time she got it, the Champlain defense is right there.
Megan Shuck takes it behind her zone, reverses it there to Alyssa Sweet. Sweet will make the long lead pass out of the zone. One-on-one, here comes Mackenzie Baker down the side. Gets a shot on goal. Rebound gets kicked easily into the corner. Now here comes Minneapolis the other way. This is McKinney. Minnikinney across the red line. She did not have the numbers. 1-on-4, so she dumps it in. Good job dumping it to the far side where she has some forecheckers ready to go, though. Now a centering feed. Nobody home for Minneapolis. And Trapp gets it now for Champlain Park. She makes a pass through center. Schwartz tried to kick it with her skate, and she missed on that attempt. Minneapolis plays it up the wall. Offerdahl. Gaffney. Alex Gaffney goes near side all the way to Chrisman. Chrisman edged out of the puck there by Shook. That pass too far for Trapp. Ava Miller goes D to D nicely. Over to Knight. Puck gets played out. Champlain Park needs to tag up. Should be offsides here, and they are actually going to blow their whistle.
Well, you know, if you notice in that last minute or so, Minneapolis has done a very good job controlling the puck. It's that one attempt here, and Champlain has not gotten the chances now that they had earlier in the first period. So, but when Minneapolis moves the puck around and puts passes on sticks and they're caught, they're controlling it well and keeping Champlain Park off balance and making them chase for a change. They got to continue to do that and then take it in offensively, keep moving the puck.
Here comes a chance for Minneapolis as they race down the left side. Melnick has it. Melnick all the way in, and then she shoves it right into the pads there of Brooke Freeman, who did an excellent job of coming out a little bit and cutting down that angle and making it a difficult scoring chance. Look at this move by Melnick. She just persistent, kept the bouncing puck moving forward.
A little spinorama there, and got a good opportunity. Melnick has been a good aggressive force for Minneapolis.
Shot there off the side of the goal from Erica Lieske. Puck in front, and there's a chance, rebound, puck still loose. Lucy Riley just couldn't quite get her stick on it to cut that lead in half.
Best attempt they've had all night, though. They're mounting an attack.
Oh, bouncing puck on net there. Those ones can be dangerous, but Schultz handled it nicely. Here comes Minneapolis after putting perhaps their best attempt, best scoring chance of the night. They'll bank it off the boards and out of the zone. Sutherland regains. Now Minneapolis with it. Good stick by Schwartz. Gosh, is she good at stealing the puck from other players. Schwartz gets it back and has a chance. Cannot finish. Schwartz has earned herself some great scoring opportunities tonight and just has not been able to finish the job.
There's a shot stopped short, but there goes on net. Another one goes on net on the rebound. And there was another one that was loose. Minneapolis couldn't. And then we got Schwartz coming in all by herself. But Schultz was just on the end. And
yeah. Well, that should have been a penalty there at the end. Julie Offerdahl hit her pretty hard from behind.
I think they're getting a little tired of Miss Schwartz down there. She's been really creating havoc.
Nice forecheck now by Trapp. Trapp takes it away. Trapp on her backhand, puts one on, and Wood had a rebound attempt. I can't tell what stopped that puck from going in. It may have been Wood just trying to get a deflection. It looked like she might have beat the goaltender to the near post. Puck gets dumped back into the corner. Only just over 10 seconds to go here, so Minneapolis trying not to give that late period goal that they did in the first period here in the second. Champion Park, Wood wraparound attempt, and it's in. The Rebels do it again. A late period goal as this first line for the Rebels continue to work, and finally it pays off with their first goal of the second period, and now a 3-0 lead.
A lot of muck in front of the net, but Goldie got caught up on the left side, and she had on the right side. Had to get back over to the right as Trapp came around, I think. And then Trapp right there. Oh, Wood comes around like that with the backhand and then just gets it in. Lifts it up a little high, gets it up over the shoulder before Schultz could get to the soft post and put one in.
Boy, that's one of those things where the goalie had the leg pad perhaps there in time.
Yep.
And the defender's stick served as a ramp and got that puck up over the pad. The angle, Wood was not going to be able to lift that puck over the pad by herself, but she hit it hard enough and it went off the stick of the defender, which trickled over the pads. That's just kind of bad luck for Minneapolis. What appears to be good defensive effort ends up in maybe helping get that puck over the pad of the goaltender Schultz, and that's just kind of what hockey bounces do, right? You work that hard, and you were that persistent on the forecheck, sometimes it just pays off.
The puck bounces to those who doth work hard, and the Rebels really have. I mean, their forecheck has been really, really good. And Minneapolis has been able to break it occasionally, but not often enough. And, you know, I think part of it is some of them are starting to get tired, Minneapolis is. And that's what happens when your legs aren't moving and they're getting stiff and tired. All of a sudden, you can't reach out and stop the play from going around the net like Wood just did. But overall, Schultz played a good period. Just bad set of luck, like you said. And we're watching a little chuck-a-puck here. Interesting, but Champlin kept up that raging forecheck in that second period. You know, sometimes you can have a letdown, especially when you get a lead, two-goal lead. And they continued. They were very consistent in that period again and kept it going. So, you know, Minneapolis got to figure out a way to break that and get some more scoring opportunities.
Well, Coach Coltis has worked his way over to the back of the goal there. Now John Jacobson has the coach of Champlin Park.
Thanks, Joe and Dan. And Jim, two periods, two light goals. And how big is that going into the third period?
Well, it's huge. You know, we had just sent that blue line out there. We told them, hey, there's a minute left. Stay out the whole time and try to get us here one more. Their goalies played really well, but, you know, that hurts them a little bit going up 3-0 after that shot. I think they were hoping to be 2-0, anybody's game at that point. But I think this 3-0 is going to help us relax a little bit.
Seems like your team's playing some good hockey here the last few games. What have you seen from your squad?
you know, we changed our forecheck up a little bit, and we just asked the kids to be a little more aggressive and a little more consistent on what they're doing. And it's really working well tonight. We're letting our defense be a little more free to jump in the plays, be a little bit more active. I know we risk maybe giving up one goal in the other direction, but it's helped us hold the zone and have more zone time and keep the puck 200 feet away from our net.
Your returning varsity players are used to playing in this tournament. What do they look forward to, or what do you tell them about this tournament as you come into these 3 days, 4 days this year?
Well, one is I just tell them it's a fantastic facility to play in. I mean, we get a great ice sheet, and all our section games are on a small ice sheet, and where we play a champion, of course, we're on that large ice sheet, so it helps us there. So we talk to them a lot about things we want to do as we progress towards sections on a small sheet, and how are we going to prepare for that, what are we going to do out here on the ice with the small ice sheet, our plays, and different forechecks and things that we want to run, and that's really what we focus on.
Finally, now you've got some tough games coming up after the first of the year. What's the biggest challenge for your team to try to win some of those games against some good Northwest Suburban teams?
You know, I think really it's just us believing that we can do it. I mean, I think we have the talent. I mean, our first line plays as good as anybody's. Our next two lines are getting better and better every day. They work hard in practice. I think it's just the belief that they can do it, and if they can put forth the hard effort, and knowing that, you know, as you work your tail off, you may not come out on top, but at least if you work your tail off, you're going to give yourself an opportunity. And really, besides the Maple Grove game that beat us 7-1 this year, we've been in every hockey game this year. And so I'm hoping that continues down the stretch.
Finally, one more question as a parent. I know your son's a senior at Champlin Park, playing some varsity hockey this year, played on the baseball team that was second in state. How much fun is that for you when you get a chance to see him play?
You know what? It is awesome. It's funny because just as I was walking over here to do this interview, he texted me, said, "Dad, we just beat Red Wings 7-4. So he was pretty excited. So the boys, Champlin, great job tonight beating Red Wings 7-4 down there. So, yeah, you know, it's hard when you miss a little bit of those things, and plus coaching softball, I miss a little bit of the baseball. But with the new lights over at Champlin Stadium this year, I think I'll be able to catch quite a few more games.
Jim, thanks for your time. Good luck the rest of the game tonight.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Thank you.
Jim Colt is head coach of Champlin Park. His team up 3-0 on Minneapolis through two periods. We'll take a break, come back with more of the Holiday Classic here at New Hope Ice Arena live on CCX Sports in a moment.
What makes your community feel like home? Is it knowing what's happening in your neighborhood? Or when people know your name? Connections make us a community. For more than 30 years, Northwest Community Television has connected citizens, neighbors, even sports fans through video. As life gets busier than ever, we will still offer you a connected community experience through CCX Media, so you can stay connected to the place you call home.
I want to eat apples and bananas. I need to eat apples and bananas. Why can't I eat?
One in five children struggles with hunger in America. Support the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks to help provide meals to those in need. Join us at feedingamerica.org.
doesn't see race. Love is love.
I'll never forget the day our landlord called and said, read your lease. No pets allowed. My owner tells him my dog ate the lease, but that didn't work. And now I'm stuck in a shelter. But this pit bull is ready for a new crib. I'm loving, loyal, and play well with others. So don't be intimidated by all my muscles, because the biggest one I have is my heart. That's right, I said it.
Vice Arena through two periods of play. Champlain Park leads Minneapolis 3-0 here in the Holiday Classic. John Jacobson joined now by two former Rebels players who have skated in this tournament in the past, Emily Colford and Kaylee Martinson. Kaylee, I remember you had a great tournament last year, at 8 goals in this tourney, now playing college hockey. What are your memories of playing in this tournament? Because your team had a lot of success here over the years.
I mean, this tournament is probably the best tournament we've been in. We've had so much fun over the all 4 years of playing it. We won the championship actually last year, so that was super fun.
How is it watching from the stands? Is it a little weird?
It's really weird. I wish I could be out there so bad, but they're playing really good. They're working so hard, so.
What are your favorite memories of playing with some of these girls and some of your past teammates who graduated, like Emily and some of the older girls?
I miss it so much. I'm actually super close with all the girls, all the seniors from last year. This whole team was like a family to me. I miss them so much, but I stay in touch with them all the time, so.
You've continued on with hockey. You're playing college hockey at Wisconsin Superior. How has that gone so far?
Super fun. I love it. It's way different from high school, but it's a good experience. Super fun, so.
What's the biggest difference? I know it's a Division III school, but still got to be a step up, I'm sure, in competition and practice and intensity. What's the biggest difference for you?
I mean, it's a really big challenge. Everyone out there on the ice is so good. It's just a big challenge, and you just have to play your hardest every game. I mean, just like high school, but it's just a big competition every game, so.
How's the season gone so far?
We're doing actually good. It's super fun, yeah. We're doing pretty good. I mean, we're losing maybe a little more than we're winning, but really close game, so.
Kaylee, thanks for your time. Good luck with the Yellow Jackets the rest of the season. Yes,
thank you so much.
Emily Colford, also a 2016 graduate, not playing college hockey. So for you, what is this like watching your old teammates and your old team?
It's so fun to be here and like watch all of them. It makes me miss it so much, and I just want to suit up and play. So yeah, I just miss hockey.
Tell me what you're doing this year.
I'm at a freshman at University of Minnesota Duluth, and I'm currently undeclared, but I think I'm going to go into the communications field and probably be a marketing minor as well.
How much have you enjoyed school so far?
It's hard, but I think it's really fun. It's a good experience to be out on my own and to grow.
Do you get a chance to play hockey or to skate anymore?
I can play intramural hockey, which I'll probably do, and like there's like pond hockey that I'll play. So, I mean, I always want to, all my chances I can get to play, I want to take them. So yeah.
For you coming back to this arena, what is this like? What memories come back to you playing in this tournament?
It just makes me miss it, and just like watching from out there, just. It makes me sad because it was so much fun to be in the locker room with everyone and just like dancing and getting excited for the games. So yeah, brings back a lot of memories.
Your old team's playing pretty well. What have you liked how the Rebels have played tonight? What have they done well?
I think that they've been skating really hard and they're getting to the puck and they just need to keep going at it and hopefully come out with a win.
Emily, thanks for your time. Continued success at UMD.
Thank you.
Emily Colford, Kaylee Martinson, two 2016 graduates. Big parts of the success of Champlain Park girls hockey here in the past. We'll take a break, come back with more. Our third period of play up next. Champlain Park Minneapolis girls hockey continues in just a moment.
Most of my family, they never graduated high school or even let alone go to college, so I'm trying to break that barrier. Every day after work, went straight to school, studied hard, and it paid off. I could not have done it alone. I see the future is really bright for me. The high school diploma is just added to the confidence, and now I feel unstoppable.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
They said a bottle was just a bottle. That no one would ever notice me. But I knew I could be more. That one day, I would make people smile.
And welcome back to the New Hope Ice Arena. And the Armstrong Cooper 21st Annual Holiday Classic. Second period highlights here with Champlin Park entering the second period up 2-0. And they continue to put a lot of pressure on Minneapolis in this second period. But Minneapolis responded with a little bit of pressure themselves. You're going to see Champlin Park here on the attack, getting some scoring chance. Nice little rush here. Mackenzie Baker with a shot and an opportunity and a great chance here from Lauren Melnick. That door quickly closed by the sophomore goaltender Brooke Freeman. And Champlin Park with a late goal here with 2 seconds remaining. And the persistence and the continued hard forecheck there resulting in a goal. Kaylee Wood gets her second of the game. Shots on goal 23-11 in favor of the Rebels. Scoring chances 8-2. Minneapolis with the only power play of the game, 0-1 on that attempt. And there's your second period stats and highlights. Let's take a look now at previous years. As you can see, Champlin Park really a big fan of this tournament, especially the last couple of years, looking to three-peat here as champions.
See down in 2009, the Rogers Royals. Jim Koltis was the coach that year with them.
Rogers Royals, what a fantastic hockey community.
Joe, would you just happen to be from Rogers?
Little bias.
I see. That's good. My son happens to be the boys' lacrosse coach at Rogers High School, so I kind of like that community too.
And that's he's turning into a little bit of a lacrosse hotbed now as well, as a lot of the young hockey player boys and girls are grabbing the lacrosse sticks, and it's catching on, Mr. Ficken.
It is, and they're getting pretty good. They won the Mississippi A Conference last year. Good win over St. Michael Albertville, but good all-around programs there.
Well, for Minneapolis, down by 3 goals here as they enter the third period. Beyond not giving up a goal at the end of the period, what are some things that they can continue to work on to get back in this game here?
Well, I think they got to get their top line out there a little bit more. They seem to be the ones generating. Every time Champlin gets in trouble, out comes that blue line, as Jim Koltis calls it, get them out of trouble. And Minneapolis needs to utilize their best line right now in this third period a little bit more and give them better opportunities. So we'll see if the Gaffneys and Chrisman and that crew can get going here. Their goaltending has been solid, Joe. I mean, he's done a really good job. And if they can get one goal, it gets them back into within 2 goals and just take it 1 goal at a time. Throw some rubber at the puck and see what happens. And the Champlin coaches are late again, Joe. Oh, my gosh. Look at that. He's running.
Too busy texting his son. Oh. He's asking his son, were you respectful of the coaches?
I love it.
I'm glad you won, but did you hustle? Were you respectful? Champlin Park. Continue on the forecheck here with the 3-0 lead. Here comes a 2-on-1 chance for Minneapolis. Down the side, here comes Gaffney. Gaffney, what a back check there by Trapp, as Trapp continues to work hard and get in the mix.
Wow. And the puck runs into a little water and gets stuck. But
sticky puck. Minneapolis recovering now. Inside our own zone is Jane Carlson. Carlson plays it up and ahead. Deliski. Now over to Chrisman. Chrisman through the middle. Got a shot toward the net. Missed. And the Rebels play it back out to center. And here comes Alyssa Sweet. Puts the puck towards the net. Chasing after her own opportunity now. Off the wall it goes. Keeping it down low as Lever. Tries to center it. It'll be covered up there by Schultz.
Boy, the speed of Champlin right now, Joe, is very, very evident.
They're getting the puck out. And that's the best breakout they've had. A one-man carry, and she took it all the way down the ice. Boy, they keep using that speed, I'll tell you. We'll see how Minneapolis' legs are in this period, too. They've been playing so much defensive hockey. They might not have a lot left.
Minneapolis gains control now, and it's Leeske. Nice cross-ice pass. Riley, right as she hit the blue line, threw it on net. Freeman was able to play it into the corner. Lever back to get it. Puts it up through center. Catching it there was Williams. Williams had it taken off her stick. And now Champa Park will toss it into the zone as the Rebels go for a line change. Whitney Knight back to get it. Knight skates up through center. Gets across the red line. And then has the puck poked off their stick. Boy, they really defend the lines well.
They really do.
They defend the blue line well on their offensive zone. Defensively, they really defend both the red line and the blue line. Close the gaps. I think what you see from Champlain Park is they have really good skating defensemen, and therefore they can keep the gaps really tight. It's really tough to get into their zone.
Yeah, and then they can turn it on you real quick with those quick feet. A couple of their they've been able just to really rock and get it going back into the Minneapolis zone.
Chandler Park dumps it in on goal. And they chase after into the corner. Rebels winning the race there. Mackenzie Baker over to the far side. Grabbed by McKinney. Based off the boards. Back down low now. And back to get it goes Whitney Knight. Knight finds some skating room. Gets to that red line. Now inside the zone. Knight then has her shot blocked. Great stick work there by Alyssa Sweet to get her stick in there. They played up the wall to Schwartz. Now Sweet pokes it in. Good chance there. She goes for the wraparound instead. There's Schwartz.
Beautiful.
Schwartz off a great effort there from Wood. Put it out front. Schwartz has worked so hard in this game and finally gets the reward as Wood puts it. Beautiful pass on her forehand, and Schwartz puts it in the goal.
One times it up into the upper corner, but Wood was the play right there. I'll tell you what, she turned it around, turned the Jets on. She got that puck, brought it around, and watch what happened. She had her head up, she gets it out front, and there's Schwartz sitting right there. Look at that, look at that. That's a sniper. What a nice shot. Now Schwartz works very hard so far this year. Like you're in this game, Joe, as you said, you called her a lot, especially on the forecheck, and now she gets rewarded.
Trapp just misses on that attempt. Puck gets played back down below the goal now. Trapp tries to center it, held into the point. Nice job by Lynn, but Lynn couldn't keep it in. Now back to get it goes Shuck. Shuck gets it taken away, played back down to the corner by Chrisman. Nice pass out front there by Chrisman. Tried to find Leeske. Leeske couldn't pull the trigger quick enough, and here comes the Rebels the other way. Schwartz down the middle, puts a shot right on, and that one is gloved cleanly by Schultz. So we're in a face-off coming down here in the Minneapolis zone.
Well, there we go, the Champlain D again. Doing a good job there with Wood coming through, and Schwartz just lifting it up there, getting the fourth goal, but Minneapolis came right back. Got a nice setup. Got the triangle set up good. Got it in the shooter's hands. Just no time. Champlain's D is on you right now. You don't have a minute to breathe.
Lever on the forecheck. Plays it back down below the goal. Sutherland pinching it from the point. Couldn't handle that puck. And Minneapolis able to play it out to center. Melnick enters the zone, but always getting pressured by multiple defenders. Loses it there as Lever takes it away. Lever across the red line now. Down the right side, puts a shot on goal. Easy one to handle for Schultz. And she'll hang on for another faceoff inside the Minneapolis zone.
Boy, Champions just relentless, you know. That blue line, they're not letting them do anything. Maybe that time for Minneapolis to step up and dump it in, but you know, with the rate they're losing the one-on-one battles on the boards, that's probably not an answer for him either.
Shot from a tight angle there, and the net comes off for a quick stoppage. Baker
right on a real estate there, shoved it off the side of the goal. Minneapolis trying to get the puck out there. Rebels on the forecheck again. This is one of their younger lines out there. Molly Colford plays it back down in the corner.
We just interviewed
a Colford in between periods there. I'm guessing this is a little sister, and little sister draws the penalty. Molly, only a sophomore on this Rebels team. Colford gets tripped. Getting her stick in there was Lucy Pham, and Pham will head to the penalty box for 2 minutes for tripping. We see the Champlain Park power play for the first time tonight. Sutherland, a defenseman for the Rebels, down low on the power play here, tries to center out in front, looking for Schwartz, and they could not connect. Here comes Trapp with some speed down the right side. Good cut! Made a little move there and almost had herself a good scoring chance without even having to set up the power play. Now Sutherland behind the goal. Oh, centering feed, Wood nearly had the hat trick. Now a chance for Sutherland, and Minneapolis is able to clear it. Skinning it to center was Leeske. Leeske takes into the zone, but gets harassed there by Schwartz, who takes it right off her stick. Schwartz to Trapp. Trapp into the zone. Trapp, nice pass to the far side for Wood. Wood back to the point for Shook. That shot through traffic. Makes it on goal. Now a backhander. Schwartz had a wide open goal and couldn't get the right angle. Now Shook from the point. Skates to the middle. Gives it to Trapp. Trap from the top of the circle. She lets one fly. That misses wide. Banks off hard off the back wall, nearly out in front of the net. Wood just lost the handle there. Sutherland recovers. Now a center feed. Backhand chance there. Good look from Wood. And now we're going to have a whistle as Schultz finally able to cover it up.
Good opportunity there for a little flutter puck and good screen by the Rebels. Created a good opportunity there. Schwartz just couldn't bring it around to the right a little bit more to get it in there. She had the opening. 31 seconds left in the penalty now. Second unit out for the Rebels.
Under 30 seconds to go, and the puck just left the zone there. And we've referred to this team as Minneapolis throughout the night. It's kind of apparent as this game goes on how much you like to have a mascot as an announcer. It's Minneapolis right now. They're searching for a mascot. They used to be the Novas, but they're looking to find some congruency between their youth programs and their high school programs. And their youth programs currently are split into two separate ones based on kind of geographic areas of the city. And Minneapolis, this team here, made up mainly from two high schools, Washburn, and they have access to all the high schools in town, but Minneapolis Washburn and Minneapolis Southwest makes up the bulk of this team. There is a couple of South players, Minneapolis South. Just give you a little background on this hockey program and where they came from. One-timer out in front, good chance there from Mackenzie Baker. Shot on goal there. Schultz hangs on to it, now gives it away as they keep the clock moving here. Under 10 minutes to go. Minneapolis brings it to the Champlain Park blue line, but Champlain Park again just continues to defend that blue line as if it's a goal itself. Do not want to let you into the zone. Wood with a little gust of speed. Here comes Wood for the hat trick, and a nice kick save by Schultz. Puck gets played into the corner. Trapp gets it. Trapp takes it behind the net. Looking. Surveying the defense. Now gets it right into the slot area. And that's where she'll let one rip. And she just misfired. Puck bounces on the back of the net, and that's going to create a stoppage of play. 8:55 to go. Chandler Park leading 4-0.
Great move by Woods here. Splits the D. Chet, looks like it's kind of slipped up her stick a little bit, Joe. Didn't quite get everything on it she wanted. But boy, I'll tell you what, the Rebels are putting on a clinic on how to forecheck and cycle. Man, oh man, it's impressive.
They don't, you know, up four goals, they're not backing away. And that's, They got the little killer instinct in them, and I like that. Chrisman brings the puck into the zone. Just getting denied. Every time they get into the zone, they just cannot get a shot off.
Well, she at least got it to, you know, 5-6 feet inside the champion's zone. First person's been able to do that for a while.
Wood plays it back down to the half wall. Centering feed, one-timer, what a chance for Trapp. And Schultz was ready to make that save. Fantastic opportunity as Wood continues to impress here. Look at this feed.
Oh, this line, this combination has been very, very effective since the beginning of the year.
He says sometimes he splits them up a little bit. After this game, I don't know if he'll ever think about splitting them up. Boy, they look good together.
Oh, boy. They really rock. And, you know, Joe, the big thing about that blue line, that line that Jim talked about, to get them out of trouble, too, especially when the other team's taking some momentum, they come right in and just turn it right around.
Schultz had lost her stick. Her defenseman, Winnie Knight, went back to the behind the net to get her stick. So here you had a rush from Champion Park, goalie no stick, and a defenseman behind the net getting the stick.
Hanging tight to the post, a good use of the stick. But Champa comes back with it too. I mean, man.
Good board battle right here between Minneapolis and Champlain Park. Levered into all the work for Champlain Park. Puck gets played to the far side now. Melnick wins the race. Now plays it back to the near side. That's where Lucy Riley will get after it. Riley's pinned up against the glass. Able to dig it out now. It was Lucy Fahm, but she couldn't get it out. Now it's Riley right back where she started along the wall. And nice pinch by Haley Williams to keep the puck active and keep the puck down deep for Champlain Park. Sutherland sneaking all the way down the slot. Look how aggressive she plays as a defenseman. She is at the dot. I mean, having some confidence in your skating ability to play that low and come down.
Well, she may be small, but she can motor. She's got good balance, good control. Good player. When Coach Colt has talked about, you know, some of the skill on this team, he was right. They have some skill on this team. About six, seven players deep. And they've done a good job to showcase that today and put it together. The Traps, the Woods, the Sweets, all of them are just standing up really good and doing a good job of, you know, putting pressure on the Minneapolis team and putting some pucks in the net.
Your goal scorers for tonight, Schwartz has a pair, or sorry, Wood has a pair, Schwartz has one. And then you got Gierwald getting her second of the year into the mix there. So three goals from that top line, continuing their scoring from a night ago. Right where they left off, Kaylee Wood had a hat trick in the first game of this tournament. She's one goal away from getting a second hat trick. Schwartz had two goals and three assists last night, and she's got a goal and a couple assists here tonight. Adding the stats a little bit, this top line of Champlain Park in this tournament, as Champlain Park looks to win their third straight Armstrong Cooper Holiday Classic. They're going to start naming this the Rebel Classic pretty soon.
Keep it up, they might not get invited back. They just win too much. We don't want them anymore. You can tell them by talking to Coach Goldus and you know, the alumni, you know, Cofield and Martins, and how much they like it.
Here comes Baker with a rush down the middle. Great back check by Minneapolis' Jane Carlson. What hustle from Carlson to deny that scoring chance. Bouncing puck now. Turnaround shot from Williams missed wide, and puck goes back behind the goal. Williams retreats it, now sends it right through the crease. Gaffney. Puck gets played back down low now. Rebels back after it. Peterson plays it to the near side. After comes Molly Colford. Colford down the left side, shoots it right into the defenseman. As Offerdahl blocked it. Offerdahl's pass was a little bit behind Leeske.
Joe, I got to tell you, that has killed them all night. They put a lot of passes behind their charging players. They bounce them off sticks. And every time they've done the mistake, Champlin jumps on it because they're right there.
Chrisman wins the race. Chrisman puts one off the post! Oh, that one snuck through Freeman. No idea how that got through, but luckily for Freeman, her best friend was waiting behind her. The red iron. Oh, boy.
Well, take a look at that. Looks like it's got stuck between her sleeve and her chest. Oh, no, that dropped down into the five hole. Oh, man, that was close. Oh, no.
I think he had it right the first time. I think it kind of snuck through her glove area there. And got the post there. You know, if with no contact, it probably would have went in, but she got just enough of it to send it off the post. Oh, look at that slow-mo.
Oh, yeah.
CCX. Yep. Slow-mo. That one hit the post square, too, didn't it?
Yes, it did. Well done. Nice framing. I love that.
Wood back to get it behind the goal. Gives it off to Trapp. Champlin Park just trying to figure out the right angle to break this one out. Here comes Trapp. Now she'll go up the middle. Perfect breakout pass to Wood. Here comes Wood. She's got Schwartz on her left. A little bit too far, but Schwartz catches it anyways. Schwartz sends it towards the goal. Gets blocked in front.
Boy, if she just could have got a little bit more to the right, Wood was standing there with an open stick unattended. She could have just directed that one in.
Sweets moved back up into the offense here. Trapp's moved back to the defense. Puck goes into the corner. After it goes Miller. Miller will reverse it to the far side. Breakout pass a little bit too far. They're just not going tape to tape. That's just the difficulty Minneapolis is having. They're just not making the couple of passes that as needed. Race for the puck now. Nice reversal by Foss, which leads to the breakout. Minneapolis gets it at the neutral zone. Jumps right back in. Now Trapp goes cross ice. Nice pass to Sweet. Sweet gains the red line. She'll toss it in on goal. Schultz then leaves it for Offerdahl. Offerdahl banks it off the wall and chipped to center now. Lever wins the race to it for Champlin Park. Now she's tied up along the center ice boards and it's dumped back into the zone by Williams. Off to get it is Peterson for Pham. Pham gives it back now. Too far for her partner, Offerdahl. Now Pham goes after it, tied up along the boards, plays it up the wall and out of the zone. Nice job chipping that one to center by Hansen. Offerdahl will take it into the Champlin Park zone before it's taken away there by Williams. Williams trying to get some help there. She was on her backhand awkwardly in the slot area of her own net. And Champlin Park will play it off the glass and out of the zone. Minneapolis regrouping here at center. That's Jane Carlson getting away from the pressure of the Rebels. Carlson gets it back here, tries to kick it skate to stick, but couldn't do so. But it, luckily for her, it was right on her teammate's stick. And Minneapolis got a soft backhander towards the goal there. Carlson pinches in, pins it up against the boards. And the Rebels will chip it high off the glass. And again, out to center. Nice play again, just kind of relieving the pressure. Williams gains control, hard off the far wall. That's going to be no icing as it went through plenty of traffic. Carlson back to get it for Minneapolis. She rings it around the boards. Waiting for it there is Alex Gaffney. Gaffney makes a nice little touch pass as Minneapolis is able to get it out to center now. Melnick as it knocked off her stick right as she entered the zone. Great defensive effort there by Shuck. And now getting control is Heerwald. Minneapolis coming into the zone with Leeske. Leeske shoots one that gets deflected wide of the net. Baker plays it out of the zone for the Rebels. Knight threw it back in. Now Wood. Wood showing some speed there. Gives it off to Sweet. Sweet shoots one from the top of the circle. Handled cleanly by Schultz. Now a rebound attempt that played aside. Schwartz just inside the blue line. Keeps it in. Sweet pokes it forward. And Schultz will get the opportunity to pounce on that puck, and she will hang on for dear life. Just under 30 seconds to go in this third period. And this is right about the time where Champlain Park scored in the second period. And they'll keep that top line in the ice right now and see if they can't get a third late period goal to finish off this game. Off the faceoff win, Schwartz plays it to Sutherland, who looks for a deflection as she threw it towards the net. And Minneapolis will reverse it to the far side, racing after it. There is Offerdahl. Offerdahl tried to poke it forward, but Sutherland, nifty little play right there to keep it in and keep the offensive live for the Rebels. One last chance. Wood, Schwartz, Schwartz just over the goal. Almost did it again. And time expires here with Champlain Park continuing right where this game spent most of it, right in front of Minneapolis' net, and put Minneapolis on the defensive.
Well, really, really good game by the Champlain Park Rebels. They achieved everything they wanted to achieve. And they did a great job. And frankly, Joe, they dominated the game. There's no getting around it. If it hadn't been for Ms. Schultz in the Minneapolis net, this thing could have got away real quick.
Yeah, Schultz had a fantastic night in goal for Minneapolis. And Minneapolis got treated to a little bit of Northwest Suburban Conference girls hockey as Champlain Park gave them that treatment. And Champlain Park now one more win away from another championship here at this tournament as they will play on New Year's Eve. They'll have the day off tomorrow, and they will play New Year's Eve. For Minneapolis, it's the first game of the tournament, so they'll try to bounce back with a victory perhaps tomorrow. Minneapolis will play Wilmer tomorrow. Fergus Falls plays Armstrong Cooper. You can head out to the arena and catch either one of those games here. Two arenas here, games side by side. And then on Saturday, December 31st, Champlain Park will play Fergus Falls at 10:15 a.m. here on the North Rink, while Armstrong Cooper plays Wilmer on the South Rink. 4-0, Champlain Park goes three games above 500 now as their record improves to 9-6. Minneapolis falls to 6-8. And what a nice night for the Rebels. Really dominant performance. And for Brooke Freeman, she gets back in the net. Sophomore goaltender. Didn't see a lot of action, but she gets the shutout. It's going to look like a shutout victory on paper, and that's all that matters.
Well, she made the save she was supposed to make and did a really good job for the Rebels and gave their other goalies a little bit of a rest. Good night for the Rebels as they start to mount their attack in the Northwest Suburban here in the next couple weeks going against some of the top teams in the state.
We are going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back with John Jacobson and some Champlain Park Rebel player interviews. We'll hear their reactions from this nice performance here tonight and the 4-0 victory over Minneapolis. A quick break, and then we'll be back here from New Hope.
Your daughter just had her first breakup. Do you A, put yourself in her shoes? B, console her?
Don't worry, sweetie. This is gonna happen a lot.
Or C, find her a new boyfriend.
Nice, single boys. That was weird.
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
This is the moment I knew. His future had no boundaries.
There are some moments only the forest can inspire. Find yours at discovertheforest.org.
Oh, look, a redhead.
Staring contest!
got it.
I know.
Come alive with the forest.
The dad was cute.
You were looking right at us.
Visit discovertheforest.org to find a forest near you.
I want to eat apples and bananas. I need to eat apples and bananas. Why can't I eat?
1 in 5 children struggles with hunger in America. Support the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks to help provide meals to those in need. Join us at feedingamerica.org.
What makes your community feel like home? Is it knowing what's happening in your neighborhood? Or when people know your name? Connections make us a community. For more than 30 years, Northwest Community Television has connected citizens, neighbors, even sports fans through video. As life gets busier than ever, we will still offer you a connected community experience through CCX Media, so you can stay connected to the place you call home.
And we're back at the New Hope Ice Arena, where John Jacobson is sitting by with a couple of the Happy Rebels.
Thanks, Joe. I'm with two senior forwards, two senior captains, Emily Schwartz and Kaylee Wood. And Kaylee, 2 goals for you tonight. Congratulations. Talk about tonight's game and your team's effort.
I think we played really well, and we worked together, and it was just a team effort, and came out with a W, and it was good.
2 wins in 2 days and 4 wins in 5 games for your team. What has gone well for you these last several games?
I think we're starting to work really well together because we're communicating more on the ice, and we're talking to each other after plays and letting each other know what needs to be done to help each other out.
You guys were buzzing the net a lot. Their goaltender made it tough for you, though, didn't she?
Yeah, she played actually really good, and we just had to get our chances and go from there.
As strong as your offense was, I thought your defense was outstanding tonight. How much has that helped your team's success here in holding opponents' shots and scoring opportunities?
Our defense is actually doing really well right now. Our goalies are pretty solid right now. They're rotating, but they're both solid. And our defenders are working really hard. And our defensive zone is just good right now, I guess.
One more game in this tournament coming up Saturday afternoon. How much do you girls like playing in this tournament? You've had a lot of success here through the years.
We love this tournament. It's a lot of fun to come here and play teams we usually don't get to play and work for hardware, I guess.
Good luck Saturday.
Thank you very much.
Emily Schwartz had a goal tonight. Tell me about your game tonight and your team's game. How did you feel you played?
I think we played really good. We worked as a team, did hard forechecking. Everyone did their part.
Overall, this season, you've gotten some more wins here as the season's gone on. What's improved the most from, say, that first practice or first game to right now?
I think definitely our communication. At the beginning, like, we have a lot of younger girls, so we needed to get to know each other and, like, see how each other played.
I know you've got bigger goals down the line when you come playoffs and conference games coming up in January, but how much do you guys talk about this tournament and trying to go 3-0 here?
Oh, we talk about it a lot, obviously. This is important. Like, it's just another game, so we need to focus on the next game coming up, not, like, the long run all the time.
You get a day off. How much does that help kind of get your legs back before you have to skate again Saturday afternoon?
It's going
to
be pretty helpful. We played 2 games here, played hard, so we need the day off.
9 games left in the regular season after Saturday, starting January 3rd. What's the big key for this team down the stretch?
Our biggest key is staying strong as a team. We don't need to get divided. We need to play together and work on our D zone and our offensive zone and put them together.
Emily, enjoy this one and good luck Saturday and the rest of the season.
Thank you.
Champlain Park Rebels, a nice win, complete team win tonight against Minneapolis with a 4-0 victory. Joe and Dan, back up to you.
John, thank you very much. And a great reaction from the girls. Very excited about their victory here tonight. Dan, excellent job as always. It was fun here tonight, rejoining some winter hockey coverage. It's our favorite time of the year.
Yeah, absolutely. I just love being around the hockey, and it was just fun working with you, Joe. And congratulations to the Rebels. A really good game tonight.
Well, for the entire crew here at CCX, we want to wish you a happy new year, and thanks for watching. Be sure to check out all the great high school action coming your way in the coming days here on CCX.